Hi, this is Sean again from Movement Gallery. Today I'm here with John Clark. He's going to talk to us a bit about his work. He's one of the artists who took part in the 2013 exhibition. That was last year. So, John, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm 35. Yeah. Been living in Bristol pretty much most of my life. Started painting really quite an early age.
Yeah.
I stopped for quite a bit of my 20s, to be honest.
Yeah.
I just didn't really have any inspiration to paint at all, but sort of recently I've started again. The last couple of years, I think I started again probably about 2006.
Yeah, was there anything in particular that gave you that inspiration to start?
Not really. I just got a little bit more centred in my life.
Yeah.
There were a couple of things, but back in my 20s I was a little bit all over the place, moved a lot, just hired a bit too much, that kind of thing, you know. Got a little bit more relaxed, sort of happy with myself, and I was just able to start painting again then.
Okay, that's great. So your paintings, what inspires them, do you think? Are there any themes or any cultural inspiration in the works?
It's kind of, there's two different styles that I paint in. I've got one style where I like to do portraits, but I like to skew the colours.
Yeah.
I go for very bold colours, but quite realistic drawings. So the proportions are all right, but the colours are just way out there.
Yeah.
The other thing I like doing, I've got a very big interest in sort of Chinese, Japanese, sort of very oriental kind of imagery, and I do like to paint based on that. I like my sort of Chinese dragons, sort of authentic samurai armour, that kind of imagery, and I do like painting with that as well.
Okay, so when you do your oriental themed paintings, what sort of materials do you use to paint them with?
Ideally, in an ideal world, I would be painting with oils because I do like the feel of it. Unfortunately, sometimes you just don't have the time to muck around with that.
Yeah.
So, paint-wise, it's acrylics for me for the most part. You can blend them nicely, you can, and they dry quickly, and you can overpaint them if you need to. I have experimented with using collage as backgrounds, mostly in coloured tissue paper, because you can get some very interesting sort of stained glass effects almost going.
Yeah.
If you sort of mix that with the PVA and use it as a background, it can be quite interesting.
Okay, alright, last thing, John. Would you mind doing us a 30 second sketch off the top of your head of a drawing?
A 30 second sketch? Right, okay.
Open my eyes and finally realize all this time I've been blind. Walking this road, it seems we all fall alone, but it's so hard to change, so hard to change, so hard to change. Seems there's no way. I see so many die for it, cause we all run around these jungles living life for it. There's no change anymore but the way that it makes us lock us up. Everything becomes you identify against. We're all born in the belly of the beast, cause they need you to reach for that rather than dream, never speaking. They say your words will never mean shit. A people without a voice are just too easy. I open my eyes and finally